Yes, sir.
Questions.
First of all, good evening. Thank you guys for being here. You know, it's a toughie. You know, we got down early. We all know around the game of football, you can't rebound from turnovers, things like that. But guys stayed together, played together through the second half. You know, when we came out at halftime, we said that, you know, we was going to, you know, try to shut them down and then do what we got to do to always, you know, to get the ball back. So we got the possessions that we wanted in the second half. We just didn't execute the way we wanted to. And we all know that's our goal sometimes in the game of football.
First half, obviously, was one with that just nothing seemed to go your right way with the turnovers, with the penalties and all that. What was the toughest part about that? Was it making the mistakes, the fact that they just kept putting them in good field positions?
Putting them in good field positions. You know, a team like that, you can't put them in short fields. So that was the biggest deal. You know, we turned the ball over and put them in short fields, and that really hurt us down, you know, what we needed to do. And then when we got something going, we would make a mistake, get a bad penalty or something like that. So that's how it was, you know, in the long run.
How were you able to keep everybody settled?
I mean, you know, we always felt that we could come back from anything. And I think that was a test of, you know, our first game of the year when we came back. You know, kept pushing against Maribel. So the thing was, you know, the guys knew it. We knew that, you know, we looked at it. We didn't get the touchdown at the end of the half, but that's the way the ball bounced. But we knew that we can get the possessions that we needed in the second half, we can get back in it. And we got the possessions, we just didn't execute.
Have you faced many teams like that that was that diverse offensively over the course of the season?
Oh, yeah, we played some teams with some pretty, you know, offenses similar to that, things like that. But when you turn the ball over as much as we turn the ball over any day, you won't beat the worst team.
Coach, you have a bunch of young guys that are still coming back next season. What can they take away from, you know, having this loss and then being able to translate that into future success?
And that's what I just talked to them about, locker room. You know, it's motivation. I mean, naturally, you just cannot replace a Deion Cruz. You just can't. You know, that kid doesn't come along every year. But when you're talking about, you get your entire receiving core back, and you get your entire backfield and your quarterback back, and the tackles, they're going to build off of it. If they want to do what they got to do, they should build off of it, and they want to get back. I can tell you, you know, it's a learning curve, and we talk about life lessons. These are life lessons. You know, naturally, everybody wants to win this game, but like I explained to our seniors, these are life lessons that you want to take on to go to the next level. And for the younger guys, if you want to get back here, you know what you have to do in the offseason. And when you have this taste in your mouth, you usually don't want that taste back again. And that's usually what it is.
Would you chalk it up with the mistakes? Just you guys showed your youth a little bit in certain spots?
I think it was. I think it was a little bit of the youth and immaturity. But, you know, these guys, you know, it was a big stage and things like that. But, you know, Dr. McGrinn, you always talk. It's, you know, I know that what comes back and everything that we can do from that point. I know that. We're going to build from this. We're going to build from this. And I know that my guys don't want this taste in their mouth. They're not used to this taste in their mouth. So I know they're going to take this and go forward with it.
Around in the first half, what was the big problem in terms of throwing the ball? Was the wind bothering you? Because with that wind, I know out there was whipping around pretty good. Was that going to be your problem, or was it just they were making plays?
It wasn't the wind. They were just making plays. It was executing well with defense.
Especially when they were defending the passing game, right? You said when they were executing, they were doing a good job covering.
They were doing a good job all around.
For any of you guys, was there anything that you saw on film that you guys didn't that? I guess anything that they surprised you with from
nothing that wasn't on film. I believe that we just were so committed to stopping the run that a few passes caught us off guard, so we got caught lagging, slipping a few times. But we got a lot of young players, so I'm hoping they come back and finish the job next year.
What was the mood in the locker room? I mean, you guys are down by three or four scores, obviously. It was an unusual situation you guys were in. What was the mood like in the locker room? And anybody can answer that.
Just keep your head up. Come back, fight the next time. Come out with a different mentality. You score zero, zero.
I think we all went back to week one. We was down 20-0 against Maribel, but somehow we came together as a team. Ended up losing 24-10 because know, a simple mistake, a few mistakes in the second half, but that just showed that we can battle as a team. We just had to finish.
Yeah, and you guys actually did a pretty good job slowing them down a lot of times after they got the ball, keeping your territory, but there, that one running back, 28 obviously was difficult. What made him so hard to stop?
He's a small dude, so it's like we could close a hole, but you have to completely fill it for him not to get through. He's a slim dude. He got open field moves. He's pretty fast, so we can't give him any open field or miss tackles.
So, Deion, I know just as a senior, I mean, how proud are you of some of these younger guys that stepped up this season?
Proud of. We got a sophomore quarterback, two junior running backs. Most of our line is juniors. A lot of our defense, surprisingly, is juniors. So, I'm proud of him. I'm proud of his brother.
And then, Karan, going forward next season, I mean, you have so many people coming back surrounding you, you know, supporting you. How important is that for you as a quarterback and being a leader of this team, just to have, you know, that support group going forward and then being able to translate to next year?
I mean, it's very important. Next month, we'll be back on the same thing in the weight room. We'll be back on the same thing we battled out front.
Coach, how proud are you of this team? I know you always want to win a championship, win the last game of the year, but you know, how proud of you what these guys accomplished from day one with, you know, a young team?
Yeah, I'm very proud of them. I mean, you're talking about we overachieved. I told you that, you know, all year we overachieved. When you're talking about, you know, Deion, you know, he won a championship as a sophomore, but when you got young, so many other guys and, you know, things like that, they just have to push. They have to push. I'm very proud of them for everything that they accomplished and everything that they've done, and they kept playing for four straight quarters. I mean, a lot of teams would just shut it down and, you know, go with it. But we felt with the type of offense that we had that we were always in a game. We just needed that one break because we felt that our defense could do what it, you know, what it did in the second half. We felt that we found the formula to stop them, you know, stop them offensively, and we did it. I mean, they didn't score in the second half, but we felt that all we needed was the, you know, possessions. We got the full possessions that we wanted. We just didn't, you know, execute with it. And that was enough for us to do what we needed to do.
Real quick, maybe in the grand scheme of things, may not be as important, but in the second quarter, I think Carr had an interception and he dropped it. He would have more than likely scored. It would have made it, I don't know, maybe made it 24-16, 24-something. Didn't get the interception. And I think the very next play, their top running back broke a 30-yard run in and eventually scored. I mean, talk about that as far as I thought that was a big momentum change there.
You know, momentum shift, things like that. I mean, we started slow with things that we did. But, you know, like I said, it was just a mistake. Kids are going to make mistakes. You know, those things will happen in these type of games. In these type of games, the winner is going to be the team that executes the best and don't turn the ball over. You cannot turn the ball as much as you turn the ball over today and expect to win. That's all the Carolina's looking for. You cannot turn the ball over. Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Coach. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.